Tyson, Fury and Wilder, obviously you've seen the fight, but we're looking at a rematch possibly with them, or Josh, obviously Joshua's in the mix there, and they talk about Wilder, Joshua. How do you, sort of, first of all, the Wilder-Fury fight, what a fight it was, and how do you see this heavyweight triangle playing out eventually?
Well, personally, I think Tyson Fury won that last fight against Deontay Wilder. Rematch, I don't know if it'll be the same fight, to be honest with you. I think Deontay Wilder will probably go away and learn from that, and you know, he hurt Fury in them last rounds. Now I think he'll come out in the next fight and try and hurt him early doors. I'm not saying he's gonna, but we've all seen that he can do. You know, if he lets his arms go sooner, which is what he normally did anyway, I think that he could catch Fury and possibly beat him, which I won't want. I want Fury to
win. On the other hand though, I mean, Fury, not boxed at that level for a long, long time. It could only get better.
Yeah, true.
So again, it's another good fight. One, you know, don't want to put your house on any one of them, do you?
No, I wouldn't back any of them.
You know, I'm
going to
go Fury though.
Yeah.
Because I think he won it handily last time.
Yeah, he did, without a shadow.
And I just think, you know, them two knockdowns obviously swayed it for Wilder, but I still don't think he won the fight. Fury can keep tight in them sort of positions, and he like boxing.
You didn't
and
think then, he was going to get up, did we?
No, no. Definitely not.
Like some brilliant videos going around, where he's the Undertaker and that.
And then you've got Joshua in the mix as well, so.
Yeah, I mean, Joshua's probably playing a little bit sideman at the minute, ain't he? Especially Fury and Wilder do it again. Joshua's picking up the pieces, which is crazy, really. He'll have to fight somebody else and outside the top three, and he's the man with all the who can bring the money. But I think Fury beat him to the punch last time by getting Wilder, and then with it being such a good fight, then people want to see that again. So I think Joshua might be the one who's having to play the waiting game.
Like you just said, then I think it's like that fight. I speak to our mate Tommy Dix, Mike, and he was saying that Fury stole the thunder, hasn't he? You know, he's coming.
Well, he has
the
in a way. Yeah,
like the people's champion.
I mean, Fury went about it right as well, saying, "Well, I'm an Englishman going over there." I think he spoke about it in the right way, and you know, maybe. He is, it's true, he's gone out there when what no one else had done. Yeah. Fought him in his back garden, which no one else has done.
As mad as everyone thinks Tyson Fury is, he is a mad guy, but he's quite clever.
Yeah, he's switched on.
He's clever and he knows his boxing, you know what I mean? He does, he's knowledgeable, and every credit to him, he's done what he's had to do. Had all that time off, like you said. And
took
like
a risk, didn't he? And it's
I
paid
think
off.
He beat Deontay Wilder.
Mm-hmm.
I think the second fight will be different. I'm not saying he won't win it. I do hope Tyson Fury can get through it and win it. But I think Deontay Wilder will come out and start letting them shots go earlier. You know? Like I said, Tyson Fury, foreign heavyweight, his movement, you know, his defence and everything. I'm not saying he's going to get caught, but I wouldn't like to see him get caught early doors with one of them shots.
They're talking about Joshua fighting in April.
Dillian White, is it? Something like that.
Possibly, and then they're saying that he might be fighting this Baby Miller in America.
Right,
I've heard this one. He could fight Klitschko at Wembley in April as well. Klitschko could fight Dillian White. I don't know.
I think Dillian White deserves the shot out of the top two, out of Fury and Wilder, because, well, he boxed last time. He didn't have to, really, did he? You know, he boxed Derek Chisora, he was already beat. I think he deserves it, and he's improved as well.
Yeah, and he hurt Joshua last time.
Yeah, he's gone out with a bad shoulder. So yeah, that'd be the fight. I'd besides Fury Wilder.
Yes.
Would you rather see Joshua Wilder or the rematch with Wilder and Fury?
I'd like to see Joshua Fury, me.
Joshua
That's the
Fury.
Fight I want to see.
That's the one.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I think I'd sooner see Fury Wilder again. Because obviously Fury deserves that shot, you know what I mean? He was robbed last time, don't care what anyone says, he was robbed. I couldn't believe it, if I'm honest, I couldn't believe the decision. I was fuming, because he was robbed, so yeah, I want to see him back in with Wilder, and I hope this time, they get it right.
You trained with Tyson a bit, didn't you, when he was at Collius as well?
Yeah,
alongside him.
Yeah, he was up there for a bit.
Brian Hughes used to always say, you know, he's got everything in him, he'd be heavyweight champion if he wants to do it.
Do you know what? He's gone out there and he's put his mind to it, and Brian was good at that. He was good at seeing what they could, you know, a talent sort of thing. But he went out there and he'd done it, and it showed that he's got tough mental strength.
You're not kidding.
Even
he's come back from where he's come back from as well.
He was weak at one point to do what he did, but he's got through it, and every credit to him, and I think he'll go on and be a world champion again.
Definitely an inspiration. So, the heavyweight triangle, who prevails in the end at the top of it? in your opinion?
I mean, it's a good problem, isn't it? It's for boxing.
It's good for boxing.
And you've got such a deep division at heavyweights, and the rest are all thriving, aren't they?
I think it's between Fury and Joshua, mate.
I do.
Yeah.
I mean, at one point, before the Wilder fight, Joshua,
yeah,
for me,
definitely.
Fury's just chucked a spanner in the works, hasn't he? Mm. Unbelievable what he's done, really. I mean, he goes down as a great for me for that, to do what he's done after what he's come back from. Mm. But, yeah, between them two, I don't like to say it's Joshua up to at this point.
Yeah, probably.
But it can change. Now. It'll change that, won't it? Mm. Right now, Joshua, though.
The thing is, as well, them three heavyweights, except that Joshua and Wilder, massive, massive punchers. So if they hit anyone flush, it could be night over, it could be game over. Mm. But boxing-wise, Tyson Fury is the better boxer. Then Anthony Joshua, and then Deontay Wilder. But if Deontay Wilder hits you, if Joshua hits you, it's night night.
Yeah, one punch.
So it's so hard to pick. But you know, it is what it is. Tyson Fury and Anthony Joshua for me.
In our generation, we brought up on tales of Ali, and we witnessed Tyson and Holyfield,
yeah,
and Bow and all them days. And we had a bit of a lull, but isn't it good that we're talking about the heavyweight division
definitely,
in this
vein
again, and it's
definitely
exciting again?
Yeah, it is. It's good.
That's what we need. We need good heavyweights, because it filters down to all the rest of the weights. Then
I remember watching like some of the crappier heavyweights, you know what I mean? Because we didn't really have anyone at the time. And
Julius Francis was British champion for a long time.
Not even him.
Danny Williams.
Yeah,
people,
even worse than them. And it's like, oh, these heavyweights are crap, and then you start liking the lighter weights again, even though at one time it was all heavyweights with your Tyson, Mike Tyson and stuff like that. And then because of the crap ones, you got fed up, got more into the lightweights, but now that they've come back again, it's a bit more excitement. Mm-hmm. Good to see.
If we're judging it on a Holyfield Bowl one as well, the heavyweight division, you know.
Yeah, brilliant fights, man. And then you've got that Alexander Usyk, haven't you?
I mean,
he's
one
who,
isn't it?
Yeah. He could be a wild card, can't he? I know, what a great fighter he is. Is he big enough to fight them men? Maybe not, but you know, I'm sure he'll be moving up to heavyweight this year.
Yeah, I think he will. I don't think he'll be able to deal with the likes of Joshua Wilder or Fury, me though, to be fair.
Mm. I think he's fighting Thingy next, isn't he? Kovetkin, is it? Or somebody like that,
I've heard. I've heard the Australian, New Zealand guys, or Parker.
Good fight, actually, that.
Yeah, it's not a bad one, is it?
They're both good names, then, Povetkin and that Parker, but they are that size of heavyweight that he can probably handle. Mm. So when you get 6'5", 6'6", Roman, when the
struggle.
big man, I think he might struggle.
Yeah. Oh, it's good to get your opinions, lads.
Cheers.
Thank you very much.
Nice one, Chris. Yeah.